Okay, guys, this is a very short introduction lecture to the adrenergic agonists. Basically, I want this lecture to be just a jumping pad or a starting point or a definition of terms or ideas so that you know where you need to study next after this lecture. The adrenergic agonists are also known as sympathomimetics, and I do use those terms interchangeably through the lecture, so don't be confused by that. I will real quick explain what these three things are, the direct, indirect, and mixed adrenergic agonists, and then from there you can pick what you need to see next, okay? So what does it mean to be a direct sympathomimetic or a direct adrenergic agonist? It basically comes down to the mechanism of how the signal is propagated or the effect is carried on, all right? The picture on the right is a presynaptic nerve and a postsynaptic nerve with a synapse in the middle. If we zoom in on this synapse, okay, this is where the action is, and these are the receptors. The normal physiology here at the presynaptic nerve is that the action potential or the nerve impulse is propagated down to the end of the presynaptic nerve here. There is a series of cellular changes which causes vesicles filled with neurotransmitters to fuse to the membrane and then spill their contents. The neurotransmitters then go on to stimulate their receptors. Alright, so this is the normal physiology. The receptors are stimulated by the neurotransmitter. Alright, the green star here represents a direct sympathomimetic drug. It works the same way. It directly acts on the adrenergic receptor. That's why it's called a direct adrenergic receptor agonist. On the left side, you'll see this short list of drugs. These are examples of direct-acting sympathomimetics or adrenergic agonists. So we've explained what the direct-acting adrenergic agonists do. Let's now talk about what the indirect and mixed-action adrenergic agonists do. We know that neurotransmitter is released from the vesicles and goes off and binds the receptors. We also know that direct-acting adrenergic agonists also directly bind the receptors. So how do indirect-acting adrenergic agonists work first? Well, one way that this could work is to increase the release of neurotransmitter. So take this purple star, for example. This purple star represents a drug that does just that. Through a series of mechanisms, and they're different for different drugs, it binds to the membrane and causes more neurotransmitter to spill out. So the receptor, you can see, is stimulated, but the drug didn't directly stimulate it. Okay, does that make sense? What's another way? Well, notice that neurotransmitter kind of hanging out in the synaptic gap there. A couple things happen, usually. I mean, we know that not all of the neurotransmitter that is released from the presynaptic side is used to stimulate the receptors. Some of it is taken back up into the presynaptic nerve. It's recycled. So our next drug is represented by this orange star. This drug acts to block that reuptake. Again, the receptors are stimulated more, but the drug didn't directly stimulate it. Okay, so it's indirectly increasing the amount of stimulation that these receptors get. Okay, so lastly, there's still neurotransmitter hanging out in the synaptic gap. Some of that neurotransmitter is metabolized, and I'm going to use the example of it being metabolized right here in the gap. Various enzymes degrade and remove the neurotransmitter from that gap. Well, what if we had another drug? Take, for example, this red star. What if it is a drug that blocks the action of those degrading enzymes? The receptors are stimulated, but not directly by the drug. Okay, does that make sense? The mixed action adrenergic agonists. They do pretty much what they sound like they do. They increase the release of neurotransmitter, kind of similar to the mechanism of the purple star drug, and they also directly act on the receptors. Okay, let's go on. Okay, now on to the knowledge challenge for this lecture. Now, you may or may not know these drugs. If you do, this will be a good review. If you don't, just try and pick up concepts or categories if you can. I'm going to quiz you on the mechanism of action of each one of these drugs, starting with epinephrine. Which receptors does epinephrine work on? Alpha 1, alpha 2, beta 1, beta 2. Norepinephrine? It's almost the same as epinephrine, except without the beta 2. Dopamine? Alpha 1, beta 1, dopamine 1 and 2. How about dobutamine? Just beta 1. Isoproterenol? Beta 1 and 2. It's a non-selective beta. Albuterol? Beta 2. Oxymetazoline? Alpha 1 and alpha 2. However, it favors alpha 1 over alpha 2. Clonidine? Alpha 2. Phenylephrine? Alpha 1. Now on to the indirect-acting adrenergic agonists, starting with amphetamine. Well, amphetamine causes an increase in the release of neurotransmitter, or norepinephrine, from the presynaptic nerve. It also inhibits monoamine oxidase, which is an enzyme that degrades catecholamines. Cocaine? Cocaine works by blocking the reuptake of neurotransmitters into the presynaptic nerve, or terminal. Lastly, the mixed action adrenergic agonists, starting with ephedrine and pseudoephedrine. Both of these are similar in their mechanism of action. They both stimulate alpha and beta receptors, but also cause an increase in release of neurotransmitter from the presynaptic nerve. All right, good job.